Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Ron McKenzie Lafergie. Well, North Korea is at it again, this time claiming to have successfully tested a hydrogen bomb that could be loaded onto an intercontinental ballistic missile, or ICBM. If this is true, it's certainly a matter of concern for leaders around the world. With nuclear weapons mounted on long-range missiles, North Korea becomes significantly more dangerous. How much more? Let's discuss. Throw on your hazmat suit, it's time to answer the question, how much damage can a hydrogen bomb do? Hydrogen bombs, otherwise known as thermonuclear bombs, are incredibly powerful, much more so than atomic nuclear weapons. The first test of an H-bomb was done in the United States, which produced an explosion the equivalent of 10,400 kilotons of TNT. To put this into perspective, this is over 450 times more powerful than Fat Man. The bomb dropped on Nagasaki in 1945. Needless to say, hydrogen bombs are a force to be reckoned with. What makes hydrogen bombs different from atomic bombs? Well, while both involve a nuclear reaction, the reaction within is rather different. Atomic bombs rely solely on nuclear fission, splitting one atom into two smaller ones to create energy. Hydrogen bombs, on the other hand, mainly utilize fusion to create power, merging multiple atoms into one large one, similar to how stars form, with fission being used to set the reaction off. This allows for much more compact warheads, which in turn makes it easier to mount hydrogen bombs onto ICBMs. Since North Korea's biggest technological issue was finding a way to mount their nukes onto ICBMs, this development makes it much more likely that they will find a way, and suddenly have the capacity to launch nuclear weapons much greater distances. Just how much damage can they do with these bombs? Well, as stated earlier, some of the most powerful H-bombs have yielded tens of thousands of kilotons. The most powerful was the Tsar Bomba, an H-bomb made by the Soviets that yielded a whopping 50 megatons, or 50,000 kilotons worth of TNT. This would be enough to wipe whole cities off the map. However, the bombs we're seeing out of North Korea are significantly less powerful than these super destructive bombs. With the recently tested bomb in particular, there is a bit that we know. North Korea has issued statements on it, but it should be noted that these must be taken with heaping spoonfuls of salt. North Korea is known to have a bark worse than their bite. It's claimed that their H-bomb produced roughly 100 kilotons, which is 10 times stronger than the test from last year. This is enough to create a fireball 1 kilometer in diameter, with a thermal radiation radius of 3.9 kilometers. If detonated in a major city, the death toll could reach the tens or even hundreds of thousands, with just a single bomb. North Korea also claims that this bomb has the capability to be detonated at high altitudes, allowing it to be used to send out electromagnetic pulses, or EMPs, to take out power and communications in a certain area. If true, this could be used in conjunction with other weapons to incredible and devastating effect. Perhaps the most terrifying implication of this is that this is just the beginning. Considering just how powerful hydrogen bombs can be, it's very possible that North Korea could develop bombs that yield tens of thousands of kilotons of power in the next decade. Should this become a reality, it would be difficult for governments around the world to ignore the threat from North Korea. But one big question remains on everyone's minds. Do they really have this stuff? North Korea is rather well known for their propaganda and liberal use of alternative facts. The miniaturization of a nuclear warhead is something North Korea has been struggling with for some time. Considering how behind the times the country has been technologically, there's a rather significant chance that this talk of a hydrogen bomb mounted on an ICBM is simply that. Talk. With Donald Trump, current president of the United States, launching threats and baiting North Korea, it's certainly possible that this is just an empty threat on the part of North Korea. But nothing is certain, and with the safety of the world depending on it, assumptions can be a dangerous thing. So now we return to our question, how much damage can a hydrogen bomb do? If we're looking throughout history and across the globe, things look rather dire. Hydrogen bombs can deal absurd amounts of damage in a single blast. One well-aimed strike could take out just about all of Manhattan. However, North Korea doesn't have access to weapons of this magnitude, with all evidence pointing to bombs that yield roughly 100 kilotons. While this isn't enough to level a major city, the casualties would certainly be high, possibly in the hundreds of thousands. That is, if they even have these weapons. However, in the years to come, we will need to remain vigilant, in case technological advances allow them to increase their power even further. Thank you for watching Life's Biggest Questions. I hope this was interesting and informative, and perhaps led you to look into it further on your own. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to the channel down below. And heck, while you're down there, let us know what you think about North Korea. Do they have these weapons, or are they just trying to fool us all? I look forward to reading your thoughts. Until next time, I'm Ron McKenzie Lafergie with Life's Biggest Questions, wishing you the best of luck on your quest for answers.